Welcome to the November 7th, 2019 meeting of the San Diego Union High School District Board of Trustees for our student board member reports, and we'll start with Jack Farber.
So since our last board meeting, Spirit Week, Pep Rally, and Homecoming was a great success with lots of participation. We are currently collecting feedback from our students to see how we can improve these events in the spring. We also had Red Ribbon Week, which was a fun week full of activities and free food that promoted a healthy, drug-free lifestyle. Our first dance performance is next week on Thursday and Friday. It's called Unbound. And tonight, our very own orchestra is collaborating with the SDSU Orchestra in a performance called Mixtape. We have a senior bonding tomorrow where we will all gather in the proscenium and watch a movie chosen by the seniors while eating popcorn and cookies. Our tennis team remained undefeated and won the open division title and now are participating in states and the individual CIFs. Our field hockey team starts their CIFs next week in the open division and are seated fourth. Water polo and volleyball had strong seasons but sadly lost in the open division quarterfinals, but water polo still will take home the title because they won league. Winter sports tryouts are next week, so sadly for me, this means I have to wake up at 7 on Monday on our day off and run 2 miles. In the week before Thanksgiving break, Raven Idol will be held in our lower quad, and to end the week, we'll have our annual student for staff basketball game, which every student loves to watch. And finally, Japanese exchange students are visiting us right now, and I today helped them pick out a bunch of CCA merch from our student store. And then my favorite Math 2 honors teacher is here to be honored, which I'm looking forward to see. Thank you, board, and I hope you all have a great Thanksgiving break.
All right, sounds like things are going well at CCA, so if Grace keeps a report on San Diego High School Academy, please.
Yeah. SDA's blood drive was today, hence the t-shirt, which was an event I co-planned this year. And today was really cool, not just because I got to skip half of my classes to help out, but because around 50 people donated, saving 150 lives, so that was really exciting. SDA's annual Battle of the Bands competition started last week, so every day during lunch on our PAC outdoor stage, we have bands competing, and our finals are going to be on November 21st at Venture Church from 6:30 to 9. And this event is actually open to the public, and the admission is somewhere between $3 and $5, so feel free to stop by. We're ramping up winter sports right now with tryouts for soccer, girls water polo, and our other winter sports this weekend, next week. We also had Canine Unwind, which is my favorite day of the semester. We bring therapy dogs onto campus and have a little puppy party. And last night I had the opportunity to go to the screening of the film Light, which is actually at LCC, which for those of you who are not familiar with the documentary, it talks about the effects of social media. And it was followed by a Q&A with author Gene Twenge, digital expert John Moffitt, and Alexa Mendez, who's an author and junior at SDA. She's also one of my best friends, so last night was kind of a proud moment. At SDA, we also celebrated Dia de los Muertos with a little festival. We had kids do student chalk art all over our quad, so that was really cool too. And that's it from SDA.
All right, thank you. And for Sunset, we have Sarah Chu.
Hi, I'm Sarah. Good evening. Since our last board meeting, many positive events have continued to unfold on our amazing campus. On October 11th, student progress reports were sent home to parents. A Sunset High School standout ceremony was also held to recognize students for positive achievements. That was really cool, even though I didn't get an award, but it was so nice. And on October 24th, there was an open house that was also held at Sunset. Parents were invited to campus to meet with staff and were served pizza to top off the excellent educational evening. I didn't go, but I heard it was nice. And on October 31st, all staff and many students dressed up to celebrate Halloween. There was actually like some really funny stuff. And the different costumes were creative, hilarious, and sometimes scary. In keeping with the wonderful campus tradition, students and staff also participated in a pumpkin carving contest, which was fun, as fun as it sounded. Ours was better, but we lost, but it still was better, just saying. On November 13th, our awards event for excellent student progress will be held with selected students to be treated to a special lunch on campus. Hope it's Mexican food like we've been talking about. On November 18th, we will begin Student Wellness Week. Special activities will be held at Sunset to promote healthy student living and decision making. Finally, I'm very pleased to announce that the construction of the new Sunset High School facility remains on schedule. Each morning on the way to school, I continue to observe the construction process, and I am excited to see that the foundation has been poured, lumber and materials have been delivered, and with the framing process soon to begin. Likewise, Mr. Ayala shared that staff in the process of reviewing furniture samples that will be eventually delivered on campus. To finish up, thank you as always, and I hope that everyone has an excellent upcoming Thanksgiving. Thank you.
Sarah, and for Torrey Pines High School, Cole Parker.
Hi, everybody. At Torrey Pines High School, next week we have our Veterans Day ceremony. We have Matt Caulfield coming in to speak to the students. He served 44 years in the military, Vietnam War vet. Very excited to have him come speak to us. Our ASB class has been continuing to help the Torrey Pines Pop Warner program, providing a bunch of resources, including our football tunnel, to help keep them successful. They're in their playoffs right now. Our Senior Doubt competition begins on November 13th. It's a fun event for all the seniors to socially bond, and very, very fun. Our spike ball, we have a spike ball tournament. It's the first year we're doing this, that is tonight under the lights in the stadium. Very excited about that. I'm sure they're having fun right now. Next Wednesday to Saturday, we have our first theater production, Don't Drink the Water. It's in the new space. It's gonna be in the smaller part, the new black box, if you will. The musical later on this year, Pippin, will be the first performance in the PAC. Homecoming dance this year was a huge success. We had it on our track for the first time. Our theme was Wild Wild West, and the dance went very well. I think a lot of the students enjoyed the Chick-fil-A catering that was there. I know I did. In ASB, we also—
You said on the track?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
All right, I heard what you said.
In ASB, we also constructed a float for the first time, and we displayed it during our halftime show of the game. Very successful, and we used it as a photo shoot at the dance. Although this past football game versus LCC sadly did not go our way, it has been bugging me for the past week, especially being part of the team very hard, but you did not want to be in that locker room after the game. But the other events, including the pep rally, Survivor halftime show, went very well. It was fun coordinating the event with LCC's ASB class, very fun to meet them, and very fun night. Well, not for us, but yeah. We have our volleyball team this past Wednesday managed to beat Bishops in the semifinals, and we'll face Cathedral on Saturday for the huge CIF championship final. Our girls tennis team won Division I CIF. Our boys cross country teams continue to dominate by winning multiple meets. Our girls golf team won CIF. Libby Fleming won the best overall score at the Admiral Baker tournament. Our field hockey won league, and our winter sports tryouts are beginning next week. As for our PALS program, they are continuing to work on challenge days, which will be next week, Tuesday to Friday. And it's a big part of our school culture, and it's a chance for students to break down social and emotional barriers in an all-day interactive event. So that will be exciting. And that's all for Torrey Pines.
All right, thank you, LaCosta Canyon.
As the first quarter of school comes to an end, lots of the seniors are finishing up their college applications. I know that I myself am getting closer to being done with mine. And underclassmen are working hard to continue to succeed in their classes. We also have a number of colleges that have come to do presentations that are optional for any student to attend to learn more about the school. The past couple weeks at LCC, we've had lots of game day traditions going on surrounding our rival football game versus Torrey Pines, which is most notably Survivor. In order to choose our two contestants to compete against Torrey Pines in the football game halftime, We had a series of physical and mental challenges that seniors competed in for the chance to become the LCC survivor. On the sports side, our football team won the away game last Friday against and now we're entering CIF and are having a home game tomorrow against Granite Hills. Last Wednesday, we had our class of 2020 senior sunrise, where the seniors took their picture on the football field in the form of a 20 that goes in the yearbook, and we all got to have VG's Donuts for breakfast. LCC also offered the ASVAB test to any of its students who wish to take it, and the test is a career exploration program that can help give students an idea of what they're good at and the careers that correspond with all those skills. This is a great opportunity for all of our students, especially those that don't have a specific idea of what kind of career they want to do. I know that a lot of my friends took it, and they said that they're all really excited to know that their results are going to come soon. Last week was Red Ribbon Week, and our PALS program worked hard to promote drug awareness, and they handed out lots of red ribbons and stickers. And finally, some members from the SDA ASB class came to visit our ASB class and observe it, which was really fun, and some of the members from our class were able to give them a campus tour and be interviewed by them. And that's all. Great.